Hallo en welkom op de channel. Mijn naam is Gerard, behind the camera is Helen. En today is a pretty special day. Because first of all, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Because I am. It's a bit sunny there. It's cold, but in the sun, it's warm. So, today, I'm gonna take you guys with me to a small village in Canton Uri. It's called Isental. And the village isn't that special, but the way up there is a bit special, and I wanted to show you guys the way up there. So that's what we're gonna do. So I will snap my fingers and we will be there. So guys, the magic still doesn't work out like it should be, but yeah, we're making a small pit stop here. This is Lake Luzern. So guys, we are driving in the Seelisberg tunnel, and that's the tunnel who connects Canton Nidwalden with Canton Uri. And now we're out of it. Afterwards we will go drive next to this road, not on the highway but below it on the lakeside, and we're driving back the other way, and we're gonna go up the mountain where the tunnel is going through. So that's a little thing, and the reason why I'm taking you guys with me is because of my job. I've been there quite a lot, and I've been driving up there with a truck. So at this point we're driving on the lakeside, and we're driving underneath the freeway. Quickly stop here. But we're gonna go up the road you see in the distance. You can see it, a car driving up there. Right now, yeah, there's a car driving up there. I saw some lights, but
yes.
There we're going up. And then we're gonna show you guys some views and a van as well. Now we are underneath the mountain, and this is the road to get up there. And these signs you will see a lot in Switzerland. And don't drive by them. Take a minute or a second to look at them, because these signs will tell you when you can drive up the mountain and when you can't drive up the mountain. Now, because there are the villages up there, there's driving a community bus as well, and these times will tell you when the bus is going up or coming down from the mountain. So if there's a time you look at your watch and it's like, oh, don't drive up because the bus will come down, and the bus will not go backwards for you. So if there isn't space, you need to back up again and drive down the mountain. Yeah, let's go. So, like I told you guys, you can see there's no room to pass each other here. You got so small places where you can pass each other, but not a lot. And the funny thing is, I drove up here with a truck and I got literally centimeters of space left in those small passovers, and the corners was all really narrow. Now we're coming to this corner and we're gonna get out of the car again, and I will show you, because this corner was the nicest corner of the whole trip up there, because in my truck I couldn't take this corner at once and I had to back up and then continue my way up. So the way up here wasn't a problem, but if you go back down the same corner as we went around before, when I said you can't take it in one turn with your truck. Now I'm afraid of heights.
Are you?
Like walking here, it's no problem.
Okay,
but I'm gonna take you to the rail here, This is getting... I'm not afraid now, but it's...
No.
It's not pleasant. I'm not comfortable.
Really?
Oh. But...
Well, yeah, that's...
Imagine coming down here with your truck, and I'm talking about a 10 meter, 12 meter truck. Driving down here, you need to brake, you need to use the engine brake, and then you're coming to that corner there. And then you think, oh, how are you gonna manage to get around that? Well, let me show you.
Alright, so I had to turn in with the truck.
So imagine standing here with your truck, as high as a truck is, and you're looking out your windscreen. The only thing you see is literally the drop. And the problem I got is I always think, what if my brakes die on me? What if something happens and you go through, because this guarding rail won't hold a truck?
No.
So driving down this mountain always was I wouldn't say scary, but it was
pushing your nerves.
Pushing the nerves, and because if something happens, well, if you're going down here with a truck, you're gone. It's end of your life there.
Oh yeah, we're going into the clouds. That's a bummer. That's really a bummer.
Wow.
What?
Well, that.
The corners.
Yeah, the small.
Yeah. Imagine this with a truck. Now, normally here's a parking lot, and here normally when the weather is good, you got a killer view as well. And now you're going to the back of the mountain. Hey, look down there.
Okay, that's so nice.
Huh?
Ooh, that's nice.
Yeah, it's really up. We go really going into the clouds.
That's
like far.
Perhaps we will get out of it.
In the village, yeah. Oh, we can still show you the village.
Yeah, this truck is really much smaller than yours.
Yeah. What? Well, I think a couple of meters shorter than mine.
Yeah.
Was. Now we're going into the clouds. It's fine. So now you can see how quick the scenery, or not scenery, but how quick your view can disappear in Switzerland. So there are some people working on the road. So here, huh? Ah, a film crew.
Yeah, filming also.
They're also filming, is it all? Funny.
Yes.
So are we? This is Isetal, this is the village. So you got some, let's say 50 houses here, and that's it. So it's a village from maybe 100, 200 people, and that's basically it. And now we missed the bridge. Oh, that's, I will, when I find the footage, because I took a picture of it, or I filmed it a little bit. If I find it, I will edit it in, because it was pretty cool to see it. Now, this part of town I went through as well with my truck. And I can tell
it's
you...
Small?
This
small?
I sent you a picture.
Yeah, you did.
Driving through this.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, that's this is it. Imagine this, driving here with a truck, and I had literally maybe 1 centimeter on the right and 1 centimeter on the left of my truck.
Okay.
So we drove through Isetal and exit the village, and we also drove out of the clouds. Now we drove for a little bit, and we're driving back to Isetal now and to go down the mountain. And when we entered the village, we're driving into the clouds again. It's funny. Yeah, so we got a little bit more. They dissolved a little bit, if you ask me. But hey, we got the narrow thing here again. And
So this was, it dissolved a little bit, the clouds here, but so this was basically Isetal. It's a really small village. You don't got the supermarket here. You got one restaurant or two, and the bus is driving up here, and that's basically it. It's a really small village. Yeah, a lot of tourists come here, and I I'm gonna tell you, I tried to connect to the internet with my phone and there's no connection here. No internet connection, no phone connection. I only can call 911 and the emergency calls, and for the rest can't call a thing. So phones are useless here. Are we going back in? Guys, I have to look on my phone to if I still got the footage of the water going down, because I was here a couple of months ago and it rained for 2 days in a row, and there's a small stream on the right side here and it goes through underneath a bridge, and that was some awesome footage because there was almost too much water going through there. Yeah. So we're going downhill again, and the famous Isetal corner. We got it here, right here. And if this person is looking, he will brake. And he does. So we're gonna show you guys this corner. Now, from the inside, from this car, you can see it as well. Look what you see when you take in this corner. I mean, you see a lake, and that's it. So, onwards.
Oh, shit,
where are you? People, when you're driving, pay attention, because I didn't and almost went straight. I didn't see the corner at all. I was sunken in my mind. So bye. This video comes to an end. I hope you liked Isetal in Canton Uri. Unfortunately, the clouds were there. So probably next summer I go back up there and take you guys with me to shoot some footage when Isetal is sunny. If you liked the video, drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and see you guys next time. Bye.